My name is R. Crosby Lyles, and this is News from the Can. Here are the bullets. Planetary conditions are ripe for catastrophic amounts of frozen precipitation. There is nothing to fear but fear itself. It's always best to prepare for the worst and hope for the best. Anyone living above the 30th parallel should have extra non-perishable provisions such as a portable generator, flashlights, batteries, extra charging capacity for cell phones, extra warm clothes, blankets, extra bottled water, extra medication, extra non-perishable food, baby diapers, Depends, flares, a flare gun might be useful, toilet paper, paper towels, sanitary wipes, first aid kit, matches, a lighter, fire starting accoutrements, etc. And it might be a good idea to carry these items in your car as well. Obviously, you can't carry, it's hard to carry around a portable generator, but you get what I mean. Yes, carry life-sustaining provisions in your car and or on your person when you're out, when you go out for any reason, because a catastrophic snowfall event can trap you alone in the elements for days at a time. Stay tuned to your local weather channels and pay attention to what the weather is doing. Check on the well-being of your family, friends, and people you know who may have difficulties with hardship. Here's why. Uploaders like Adapt 2030 constantly remind us that we are headed into a grand solar minimum. Less output from the sun means colder and longer winters. The often referenced Maunder minimum produced what is termed as a mini ice age, years without a summer. This was a period between 1600 and 1750 AD when lower solar output ravaged the planet with colder winters, massive crop failures, and starvation. The worst of this mini ice age lasted about 100 years. The two main competing schools of thought in the scientific community are that either greenhouse warming is the driver of climate change or that the sun is solely responsible for all changes in our climate. The most ideological of these competing interests on one side believe that carbon emissions are going to cook the planet into near-term extinction, near-term human extinction, while the other side argues that carbon emissions have no effect whatsoever on climate change. I am of the seemingly forgotten school of thought that believes that greenhouse warming is a prelude to rapid onset ice age, not mini ice age, full-blown ice age. And the geological clock is at high noon for just such an event. If the planetary ice age people are right, we could experience catastrophic amounts of snowfall at any time. By catastrophic, we mean literally tens of feet of snow or more, blanketing large swaths of entire continents within hours. All sides of the climate change discussion admit to the crucial reality that climate change involves extraordinary volumes and durations of precipitation. Add to that the fact that our oceans are at the top of an exponential rise in heat energy absorbed over the last 20 years caused by greenhouse warming. That energy causes more evaporation. Then, lower output from the sun during a grand solar minimum causes interior continental temperatures to drop. These conditions on their own are a recipe for massive amounts of frozen precipitation. Add to that massive temperature inversions caused by rising temperatures in the Arctic, and the stage is set for cataclysmic snowfall the likes of which no one has ever seen. Obviously, climate shifts are driven by a myriad of root causes that ultimately affect how radiant energy is absorbed by our planet. So no all-or-nothing approach will ever suffice when it comes to explaining climate change. Our planet is an enormously complicated heat engine that requires the expert processing of massive amounts of data to even try to predict, let alone fully understand how it all works. I encourage everyone to do your own research and decide for yourself. Hopefully, many will be spared the wrath of our changing climate. There is nothing to fear but fear itself, and it can never hurt to be prepared. Stay safe. My name is R. Crosby Lyles, and this has been News from the Can. Thanks for watching.